Hello, friends. You're with the Lonesome Gamer, and I'm playing Talisman, 4th edition. Playing with the dwarf, the sorceress, and the Valkyrie. And I think now the Valkyrie is in the lead. She's got a talisman. She's the only one now here who has that. And she's got that amazing weapon here, the Shamshir of Kamzin. That allows her to add 2 strength during battle. And then it says if she wins a battle, she may immediately move 1 space and encounter the next space. I think I forgot that until now. So I gotta keep that in mind. Then she managed to kill that Battle Hulk. So she's got that trophy of 10. And yeah, she's doing really good. Furthermore, she's got some money, which will allow her to visit the city and maybe buy some nice objects. The dwarf, well, he might also visit the city pretty soon. He doesn't have any objects right now. I think he's trying to get his objects back here in the ruins. And the sorceress, well, she's after that spirit here. And so maybe she also can find some more money to go shopping into the city. Okay, so let's start with the dwarf. And he's using his riding horse, trying to visit the ruins here. That's a 6. That's not quite enough. That would be the fields. Or the guardian angel over there. Well, he could go there, take the Guardian Angel. You may discard the Guardian Angel during battle or psychic combat if your attack score is less than your opponent's. And you don't lose the attack. That might be a good idea to take that Guardian Angel as a follower. Why not? Can be helpful, I guess. Okay, and then we see the Valkyrie, and that is a 2, so it's tempting to attack that ogre, and I guess she's gonna do that. So she moves here, and yeah, I mean, so she's got 7, 9, and then she can attack 1 because of her additional strength in battle. So she's got a value of 10, which is amazing, and the ogre has only a 5, so that's the attack of the Valkyrie. This is a 12. And that's enough to kill the ogre, that's for sure. Okay, so now she can actually change these 2 trophies into 2 additional strength points. And she's really rocking now, actually. I think we can maybe 1 or 2 more points, and then we really can think about entering the the inner region, actually. Okay, so now I can move one additional space. And, yeah. Let me see. Where do I want to go? I guess I move here into the city. Because this is my special special ability here with this Shamsir of Kamizin. And I can now encounter that space, and I think... I don't know if I want to. I could heal for one buck. Not sure if I want to do that, so... I find that so hard to decide. I think I will do it. I think I will heal for one gold. So I'm back at my full life points then. And then it's the dwarf again, and he also uses again his riding horse. That's a 7. That would bring him to the fields or to this ogre, but he's not that good. So I think he will end up in the fields. No, wait a second, that's not true. He doesn't end up in the fields. That would bring him into the ruins where the village was, but I think that's not good too. Damn. Okay, he can now choose between the ogre and the village. I think he prefers the ogre. That gives him at least a fair chance to... On the other hand... wait a second. I forgot again. Ah, damn it. I forgot again that it's night time. So, I forgot that also here when fighting this ogre, I'm not sure if she would have won then. Well, it's too late now. But I will remember this now, and the ogre here has a strength of 6, while the dwarf only has a strength of 2. That's not that great. So I think what I'm gonna do then is I will enter the ruins here, lose another life point, which is not good, but at least I'm allowed to draw 2 cards. And we drawn our cards here from the Highland deck because of these of this Eerie Vanguard card. Okay, well, that is not so bad, I guess. This is a Wildlander. Instead of rolling the die for movement, you may encounter the space you are in as if you just landed there. Either encounter the space or a character in the space. The Wildlander then wanders off to the discard pile. It's not so bad. And then the other one is an invisibility potion. You may discard this potion at any time to evade any creature or character until the end of the turn. Yeah, nice. Oops. Damn. Okay, so wasn't that bad. And again, it's now the sorceress. Well, somehow I'm under the impression I messed this up. I don't know, for some reason I didn't move her, I think, in the last turn. That's weird. Must have simply forgotten it. I guess. That's a little strange, actually. Did I really not move her? Seems so. Pretty sure I didn't. Okay, I think I will move her twice, so that's... I can't correct that. Yeah, I think I will move her twice now. That's weird. Okay, so that's a two. She could move in here, into the ruins. But that would cost her one... That would cost her another life point, and she only has two left, so she won't do that. So she moves here into the plains, and then she's allowed to draw two cards because of her Orb of Flames. And she can now discard one of them. So there is this one here. That's the Darkland Desert. And I think she discards that one. That would bring her on another expansion. But that is pretty dangerous. And then she's got that demigod here. A demigod grants you the spell of your choice if your craft allows. Look through the spell deck and take one of your choice. Then mix together the spell deck and spell discard pile and shuffle them. The demigod then vanishes to the discard pile. Okay, so that's definitely a cool card. So actually my spell deck is not complete. I didn't mix all the spells in because this would be something like this then. So I only have this reduced deck, and I will only kind of use the spells that are in this deck to choose from. So let's see what we find. Okay, I took the acquisition here. And I would simply use that to gain that talisman from the Valkyrie, because she is too strong in my opinion, and she will go to the inner region pretty soon. So I think it's about time to weaken her a little bit and to slow her down. Of course, there were some other nice spells. She also could have used a healing spell, for example, which would be great. But the acquisition is, I think, a good thing. That will definitely slow down the Valkyrie, which is at the moment the most dangerous enemy, I guess. So, and then I said I'd do another turn with her, because I'm pretty sure I forgot her during the last round. And... then she can actually play that spell. Cast at the start of your turn before you move, take one object of your choice or one gold from another character. So, place that one, and then she will take the talisman, and she will now place the talisman in this concealed pouch instead of the Orb of Flames. So now she's got four objects, and well, if she finds another one, she will have to discard that. Okay, let's roll a die for her. That's a six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 would be the planes. All the woods over there. Not sure. Well, I guess I move into the plains and draw another card then. Well, again, I can draw two cards and choose one. We got a Ritual Master here. Good and neutral characters must lose one life and place it on this card. The first evil character who visits the Ritual Master gains all of the life placed on this card. That's nice, but it doesn't help us for now. Maybe later. And again, the Dark Denizens. For two rounds following this turn, whenever a character is instructed to draw adventure cards, he must draw dungeon cards instead. Okay. So we start that now here with the Valkyrie. Okay. Yeah, so problem now is that the Valkyrie, she has lost her talisman. There is a high temple though. There she could gain a talisman, but she has to be very lucky. She could pray there. So maybe she should try that. Maybe she should visit the high temple. Okay, let's see. First we roll a die. Let's see where she ends up. That's a 5. So yeah, I think she visits the city now. Okay, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's the Sanctuary Square. Draw one card. Okay. Well, that's an assassin. You may pay up to 3 gold, then choose a character to lose 1 life for each gold you paid. Once a character has chosen to do so, discard this card. Wow. Well, that's tough. We could now kill the sorceress. Or the dwarf. Well, that's a tough card, man. Yeah, and it's tempting to do so. It really is. Absolutely. I mean, this... It is not... Damn, it's hard to say. I mean, on the one hand, it's great. I mean, to kill the sorceress is tempting, simply because she has stolen my talisman, and revenge is a sweet thing. So, yeah, why not? Why not kill the sorceress? On the other hand, she is not that strong, but she's got a lot of great items. It is pretty hard to tell what to do. The problem is, if she is dead and she ends up with all these items, and I mean, then she will lose all the items, and then it is absolutely possible that the dwarf will end up with all these items, which will make him pretty powerful. And now we have 2 weak enemies. And then the dwarf would be strong. On the other hand, the problem is, if this assassin stays there on that space, there's a pretty high risk that somebody else pays that him to go after me, because I'm pretty obviously in the lead. So I guess I have to do that, and it's not that expensive. I mean, it's just $2. It's sad I cannot kill them both, the dwarf and the assassin, I mean, and the sorceress. But hey, okay, I'll do it. Why not? It's a crazy thing, but I'll do it. I paid 2. I think the main reason is I don't want the assassin... I don't want to leave him here on the board so that someone goes after me then. So I think I pay the $2 and I kill the sorceress. I could also kill the dwarf though. Maybe that's even better. I mean, the sorceress is not that strong. And the dwarf, Some way he seems to be better. Then he's got that special ability here which allows him to kind of enter them the inner region faster, because he doesn't have to roll that much at the portal and the mines. The sorceress has a talisman though. Damn, it's really hard to say. Okay, it seems to me actually that the dwarf is stronger than the sorceress. He's got a little better values. He's got that strength 4. Sorceress only has a strength of 3. Well, okay, that's basically it, but he also has 5 gold, which is a lot. The problem is, if he dies, well, we will end up with one strong character, the one or the other way, if that remaining character manages to grab all the stuff of the killed character. So I think in the end it doesn't make such a difference. Yeah. Okay, I kill the dwarf. I'm sorry. Sorry, my little friend, but it's time for you to die. Orcs. Yeah, the ruins are a dangerous place. Lots of assassins there. So that's it. That's the end of the dwarf. Okay. So, we're gonna place all his followers here in that space, and yeah, also that magic object here, and the 5 gold. Okay, so now the sorceress has an interesting decision to make. She could try to go after all that stuff, which is pretty amazing, but then she will lose another life point, and she only has 1 life point remaining then. So that is quite a risk, but on the other hand, I think it's worth it, and I think she might try it actually. Okay, so that was pretty tough. Okay, so now, instead of a dwarf, we are now joined by the druid. It is this guy here. Okay, yeah. So this is his miniature. And he starts at the forest here. You begin the game with 1 spell, so let's see what that is. Well, that is Soul Shatter. Cast on any character or creature who you are about to engage in psychic combat. If cast on a character, he loses 2 lives. If cast on a creature, it is killed. Enemies killed may be taken as trophies. So that's a good card. And you may change your alignment at will. At any given time though, you can only be of 1 alignment. For example, if you are carrying the rune sword and you wish to pray at the chapel, you must ditch the rune sword. Whenever you land on the woods, you may gain your full complement of spells according to your current craft. That is pretty cool. That is definitely awesome. And he's got a strength of 2 and a craft of 4, fate 4, life 4, and of course the gold. And for now he is neutral. Okay. So here we are, and one gold, craft four, okay. So here we are. And yeah, we start right away with the druid. If he manages to enter the village now, or the ruins of the village, well, then he has a really good start, actually. Let's see. And yeah, he does. Amazing. That's a two. That is just great for him. So he can enter this area, loses one life point, and then he's allowed to grab all that stuff, actually. Is he? Yeah, he is. So that's an amazing start. And then he can enter the city right away with 6 gold. He can go shopping. That's amazing. Okay, here we go. And he's got now lots of followers here. Mule, riding horse, guardian angel, wildlander, and the invisibility potion. That's a trinket. Okay. What a good start for the druid. And it's the sorceress again. That's a four. Yeah. Well, she's not doing that good. She must heal. She definitely wants to go to the city to heal. So first of all, she moves to the fields. And then she's allowed to draw 2 cards there. Okay. So, let's see. Seems like we see the next expansion now. We got 2 events now. Okay. So let's start with that one, the Dark Tower. You are immediately teleported to the Dark Tower. At the Dark Tower, you must roll 2 dice and subtract 1 from the result. So that would be the first event. And you can only flip this card once per turn, so it's not flipped right away again. You are sucked by the transporter. See what you discover. Roll 1 die and move 2. That's interesting now. So I think we will actually... Yeah, what do we do now? Oh man, that's complicated now. I'm not sure. I don't know what happens. I'm not even sure this event occurs. That's a pretty complicated situation. Oh, wait a second. They don't occur both. I can't choose one. That's the point. I can choose one. Okay. Let's see. So this brings me to the Darkland, which is pretty risky. Because that's a... That's a dangerous area. The transporter can bring me into the timescape, which is even worse, I think. So I guess I'll take the Dark Tower and discard the transporter. Okay. So let's bring up the other expansion now. Okay, so the Darkland is now a fan-made expansion. I've shuffled all the cards. And this is the board. As you can see, it looks absolutely amazing. The Dark Tower is here. And it works pretty much like the temple. So, We now move there with the sorceress to the Dark Tower, and it's said you gotta subtract two, no, one from the result, to a minimum of two. Okay. And an interesting point in this Darkland is that there is, I don't know, some special magic in the Darkland. And every time you kill a monster or some kind of monster or creature, so some enemy there, then the soul goes into a, I don't know, some collective dark power. And the overall strength of the monsters might increase over time. So you can see here, every time you kill an enemy, you just go a little further here, and then if the marker ends up here, you have to add one, and here it's two, and in the end it would be even three to the strength or the craft of the monsters you encounter in the Darkland. Okay, so let's start, and let's see what happens there in the Dark Tower. That's a 9, so that's not so bad. We gotta subtract 1, so we end up at 8. Gain 1 life. Well, that is perfect. That's exactly what she needed. Definitely. So that improves her chance now quite a bit. Okay, and well, let's see. Yeah, it's the Valkyrie again. And she now has only 2 bucks left, which is not so great. Wondering what she could do. She could buy spells, for example. Could be an idea. I'm not sure what she will do. Praying is not that interesting at the High Temple now, because she won't gain a talisman if she pays only 2 bucks. It's daytime anyway, so she cannot... Well, she could go to the sorcerer and buy a spell there. Maybe that's an option. Why not? That's at least something. Okay, so let's see. That's a 5. So... yeah, I guess she does that. She goes to the sorcerer. She could also buy a pet. She just has enough money to do that. Well, I don't know. Sorcerer or pet? Hard to say. I think she goes to the sorcerer. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and then she's allowed to buy a spell for 2 bucks. So that's what she does. She pays 2. And she simply draws a spell then. Whoa, that's a warp gate. That's not so bad. You may cast this spell at the start of your turn. When cast, it opens a warp gate, which will remain in the space until the start of your next turn, or until a character passes through it. You may pass through the gate when you cast the spell. If you do not, any character who lands on the space must pass through the gate. Any character who passes through the gate is moved immediately to the warp gate space, which is on the time... how is it called? The Timescape board. So that's not so bad. She's pretty strong. So I think she might risk it. Go to the timescape. I think that might be a cool idea. Okay. So I guess we do one last round now. Things are really getting interesting. And yeah, let's start with the druid once again. That's a 6, very good. That's pretty good for the druid. And yeah, he simply moves here into the chapel. And well, I think he will change his alignment to good. Let me see. Where are these alignment cards? Here, I think. Yeah, that's it. Okay, so I guess it means he has a good alignment now. And then he's just allowed to pray, and he does so. That's a 5. That's pretty good. Gain 1 life. Very good. Okay. And then it's now the sorceress in the dark land. So let's see. That's a 3. So she could either move here to the step, simply draw a card there, or move back to Leah and draw another card. I'm not sure. Well, hard to say. Yeah, I guess. I mean, she could stay there for a while. It's hard to say what she want to do. I think she moves back. Doesn't really matter. 1, 2, 3. Leah. And that allows her now to draw 2 cards because of her Orb of Flames. Exactly. So let's see what's going to happen. Okay, we got an event first. That's spring. You are immediately teleported to the spring. Without rolling the die, you may throw your gold into the spring, maximum 3 gold. For each gold, you may either take 1 fate, 1 life, 1 craft, or 1 strength. Whoa, that's amazing. This is absolutely amazing. That is so great. So first, this goes to nighttime. And then we got the Dark Revenant here, but this guy stays here. So he's here for now. First, we are teleported to the spring. I wonder where that spring is. The spring is down here. Okay. So now we can That's amazing. Okay, I say we spend all our gold. I'm pretty sure this is worth it. And I guess what we're gonna do is we spend 1 for the life. So we got our full life. Here we are. And then I spend 2. And I'm gonna improve in craft. So I got 6 craft now. That's definitely good. Okay, and finally, we'll see another turn of the Valkyrie. And I'm thinking about using that spell now right away, the Warp Gate. At the start of your turn. Yeah, I guess I will do that. I will cast that spell here in the Sorcerer's Tower, open a Warp Gate there, and then in the next turn I can move to the Warp Gate space on the Timescape board. Okay, so I think this is it for now. And that was a pretty cool video, I guess. There are lots of things happened. Poor dwarf was killed by an assassination. Druid found lots of stuff, and he had a great start, is really doing good. The sorceress, I think she also was doing fantastic during these last turns. She's now in the Darklands, managed to improve her craft quite a bit, and also her problems with her life. So she's just doing very good, and the Valkyrie is still pretty much in the lead though, but she's lost the talisman. So it's not going to be an easy victory for her right now. She's got to find that talisman first. Yeah, pretty awesome. Great game. Hope to see you in my next video then. Bye.